aku mendekat.
This one's done, and this one I'm working on here. It's a simple setup, just a alternator setup for this 350. Waiting for the valve covers to get here. I'm gonna drop it in today, unless they showed up already. Doubt it, but yep. I don't know. I like the black better. I don't know, black or orange, guys, black or orange. Oh, I'm not giving this a fair shake. Let me pull this off. Hold on. So wait for the valve cover to show up on this 350 and the distributor, but I think it just showed up right now, so let me check. Sorry, terrible video guy, huh? I know it. Ah, come on. Oh no, the distributor's on this one. Tripping. There we go. Is that better? Yep. Chrome will get you home. I agree. Well, Chrome gets me home because I build them right. Spend the time, measure everything, right torque specs. Double, triple check everything before I fire it up. But these are actually my customer's engine. This one was actually I just built for fun. This one's not going anywhere. It's not sold. It's just sitting there. But yeah, this one's did I tighten that down? Yeah, this was a fun engine here. I'm done with it. I'm just going to shrink wrap it up and push it in the corner. But I like the chrome on this one. I got this from my new supplier when I met them out in SEMA. And if you look at there's a lot of blue in that chrome. Not your typical China chrome, and that's why I like my supplier. This is Chinese here. Obviously, these don't say they're Chinese, but I guarantee they are from China. But yeah. Anyways, this is CVF. I got a commercial account with them. We get these good deals on these. But yeah, this one's going. This one's $6,800 for this one. This one's brand new. It's been all new pistons, deck board, new heads, seals, springs, everything you can think of. This one's ready to get dropped in. It's even primed up. It's going to run the distributor and the spark plug wires to that. And I'm going to sell it as a turnkey, just like it is. Just bolt it in your car and hook up the gas and ignition and fire it off. It's brand new, 0 miles on it. Yes, sir. I'm in Sacramento, California, $6,800. Trust me, it's really worth it. It's brand new everything. It's fresh out the machine shop. Been decked, bored over 30. All new pistons, rods, crankshafts been polished. Heads are all completely done up. It's just perfect for a cruiser. There's no high performance stuff going on here. It's for a hot rod. Just a putter. A beautiful putter. It'll get you everywhere you want to go. And this one's sold here. It's waiting for the valve cover to show up. I always run this Edelbrock filter. I don't know if you guys ever see these, but they're worth it. The fuel line usually comes out to the side and just shoots out right here, which is a terrible spot because that's where the air clears at, and that's where it's going to rub and possibly cause a hole later, but these AVSs work good. Yeah, cool. Buy a crate engine. Nothing wrong with a Mexico block and black everything. No problem at all. These are for guys that are looking for something that doesn't look like a crate engine. But yeah, absolutely. Crate engines are just guys like me to work for. Turn this music down. It's funny, people have the idea that when you're buying a crate engine, you're buying some kind of manufacturer from GM directly, or a magical, you know, engine building facility that has high tech everything. But if you ever find out and go back to Indiana or Sparks, Nevada, or I'm drawing a blank, but they're just guys like me that work for, you know, $25-$30 an hour building engines for you. Yeah, no big deal, but I'm not knocking it. It's just the way it is. I know people can buy crate engines all day, but you can buy probably a blueprint for probably about that much. Absolutely. These are for people that don't like crate engines. When you open up your hood and somebody's got the exact same looking engine as yours, like I said, not knocking it by any means. Those guys know what they're doing. They're probably millionaires, and I'm not. But yeah, cool. But yeah, just wanted to show you guys a little eye candy for you gearheads out there like me. Whenever I was at work and I doing something, or at home relaxing, I tune into TikTok and I got my favorite guys I follow. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Felix. Appreciate you, brother. I just like watching stuff that have to do with cars and engines, lowriders and muscle cars. I'm really into street racing and lowriding. Anything to do with cars, that's my thing. That's how I identify myself. I'm sure a lot of you guys out there do the same thing. But yeah, just give you guys a little something to look at. Yeah, I don't know what else to say other than good afternoon, happy Tuesday, and happy New Year. Just finishing up some customers' bills that's going in this truck right here. So you see, it's all been painted black. It's just really dusty right now. Hey, Bobby, I'm in Sacramento, California. Bowtie Family is the website. Yeah, I'm going to dust this off right there and drop this engine in right now. And got this 200R right here ready to go. It's been serviced. I've gone through it all. That one's going in at 350 right there. Probably going to have to install a lockout on this one. We'll see. But yeah, it's going on this 350 right here. And it's got the slant. If you guys know Proform slant valve covers, the orange ones are going to go on here too. So it's going to look nice. But yeah, this guy just wants to... yeah, Joe, this one's for sale right here. This one's been sold. And this one came up for sale after this one was sold. The guy wanted this one, but it's too late. So yeah, this one's available right here, $6,800. I'll take a $500 deposit, put your name on it. You don't have to pay me now because I'm in no rush to get rid of it. It looks pretty in the shop. I'm going to start on another one. It's going to be copper and black. So basically everything's going to be black like this one, except for the valve covers will be copper. Oil pan will be copper. All the timing cover, everything's going to be copper. I built one like it before 2 years ago, and the guy who bought it off me asked me not to resell another one for a couple years until he gets this going. Well, his is not going, and it's been a couple years, so I'm going to build another one. I've been doing this since, let's see here, without telling my age, I would say 30 years. Yeah, damn, 30 years, son of a bitch. Yeah, it's been 30 years. I used to do an engine here or there on the side, and then started doing more and more when I was working for the government. I started doing more and more side work, really enjoying it. And then I started realizing, I look back, I go, man, I did 44 engines in 24 months during COVID. 44 engines in 24 months during COVID. And I go, man, I'm really enjoying this. So I actually quit my government job, and this is what I'm doing now, full-time engine building. And I can build anything. NA, nitrous, supercharged, LS, turbo, it doesn't matter. It's all the same stuff. Just some require more accurate measurements and whatnot. Yeah, so no big deal at all. Actually, Deke... no diesels, brother. You got me there. No diesels. I got an inline 235 on its way as well. I got a big old Toronado coming in. I don't know if you guys know about Toronados. They are front wheel drive, big block engines. I got a guy coming up from LA about 6 or 7 hours away to drop off his car next month. I got another one coming up this today, 63 Impala getting dropped off. I'm going to yank the engine on it. And I just got another one dropped off today. I'll come show you guys. Show you just how dirty this is. This is from a 1961 Chevy Impala, stock 283. Look how nasty this one. I just put it out here right now because I'm gonna break it down on Friday. But look at that. And I swear to you guys, the engines that I have now, they look like that. Look how nasty that is. Isn't that nasty? Just oil leaks for years and years and years and years. I don't know why they always break this. This is a vacuum canister, crankcase canister. But look at that. Look at that mountain. Isn't that gross? Thank you, brother. It's hard for me to read your... I don't have my glass on, but I think it's Pala Dumist D. Diomas. Anyway, sorry, guys. And thank you, R-U-K, Rook. Rook. Yeah, look how nasty this is, guys. Isn't that gross? I'm actually thinking about throwing it back in my truck and going to the car wash and hosing it down before I put it in my hot tank. But thank God I got a hot tank. So, at 327, I'm building for my wife. I got a 65 Nova Super Sport I had since high school. I'm going to build that up, make it stock with the L79 setup and put that in there for her. This engine's for sale. It's complete and it runs perfect. It's out of a 63 Impala. He just went with a V8 and I can't believe I haven't found a home for that yet. I haven't advertised it though. It's a 230 inline six cylinder, I believe, or 250. I got a 327 here I'm going to put up for sale after I build it. That's just a 305. I'm actually probably going to just donate it as a core. I got another 68 Impala 327 right there. That one's ready to get built. I'm going to break it down and throw it in a hot tank and send off to get machine work. I got another, I think this is a 350 there. These are all just stuff I'm going to build. There's a 4-bolt main right there. They look like crap, guys, but don't be fooled. After a shot pinged and hot tanked, they don't look like that anymore. It's like brand new metal. Yeah. So, yeah. Anyways, back over here, guys. Oh, I didn't read. I'm sorry. I didn't scroll up. My bad. I'm sorry. I'm looking at these damn messages. Terrible. Somebody said terrible. Don't know what to say. Oh, probably the quality. Yeah, the grease. 2904's here. I have no problem building a Ford, but I don't have any. What you draw to build a stock 327 at 3100? How much to rebuild a 350 aluminum heads Camite? I don't know what that means really. The labor is always the same. What you put on it doesn't matter. I usually get everything at wholesale, so same price, $3,100 to build a small block. Phil built a wicked 50. It doesn't matter. Whatever you want, hydraulic roller camshaft on a big block, highly recommended. How much for a build 327? Does I don't know. It depends on the condition of the block before I get it. You know, if I got to go spend $1,200 in machine work, the price is going to change. So I won't know the answer to that. Sorry. Rusted. Yeah, I know. Rusted on the East Coast. It sucks. Even buying cars. How much to build 327? $3,100 labor. What's your timeline on doing it full engine? Well, I just got one dropped off to me today, and I'm super busy. So I told him about a month and a half. Got any 5.3s? No, I got one on the way to the shop next week. I'm doing an LS rebuild. And I do have two on the line right now for 1300 bucks, complete in the car running LS. They're both 6.0s. Boss racks, yeah, 3100 is correct. Got any build 5.3s? No, I don't. I'm out of Sacramento, California. Rebuild a 4350, 455. It's all the same, 3100. 3100 labor. Everything's on bowtiefamily.com. All the pictures of engines I've done, everything. You have a dyno. I have a engine stand I break engines on, but dyno's for people that have high horsepower machines they want to fine tune on the deck. And I haven't had those enough to have a dyno here, so that probably I can have the machine shop do it, or just take it to the machine shop, get it built there. Anyways, can you ship me a motor? Yeah, I ship motors all the time. In fact, I have crates in the back for shipping motors. But yeah, let me let you guys go. My phone keeps vibrating because people keep calling me. I apologize. Everybody have a great day. I don't know. Check back in with you later on. Yes, I do everything myself. Everything myself. I don't let anybody turn a wrench on anything I touch because I want to make sure it's right and my name's going out on it. All right, guys. Take care, you guys. God bless you, for reals. Take care.